Today we're taking a look at these MLB matches, which are happening on Sunday, June 11, 2023 and giving you our team and total picks for today. Welcome back to High Stakes. Before we dive into our video, don't forget to subscribe and to push the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Also check out our Patreon if you want access to our premium picks. Our Patreon is a way for us to help you improve your chances of making more money. You will find the link to our Patreon in the description and comments section below. Houston Astros vs. Cleveland Guardians. Houston had plenty of chances, but couldn't put Cleveland away in the opening game of the series Friday night in their first game since Yordan Alvarez hit the Illinois. The Astros entered Saturday 36-28 on the year and stood 5 games behind the Rangers for the top spot in the division. On Friday night, Houston finished with 15 hits, led by Jeremy Pena's run, 4-hit night. Jose Abreu hit his second homer of the season to stake the Astros to an early lead, but it slipped away. The Astros were 6-for-28 with runners in scoring position in the loss and left 14 runners on base in the game. Christian Javier didn't factor in the decision as he allowed 4 runs on 7 hits with 3 walks and 2 strikeouts over 5 innings. Seth Martinez, 1-2, took the loss as he allowed 4 runs, 1 earned, on 4 hits, with 3 walks and 4 strikeouts, over 3.1 innings of work. Houston missed prime opportunities to put away the game Friday night, and they now have to work with one of their back end of the rotation guys in this one. While Bielak has been solid enough in his last couple of outings, he has been a bit fortuitous seeing that his WHIP is over 1.5, and his FIP ERA is 5.22 this season. That means he's likely due for some negative regression. Bieber has been decent though his strikeout rate is way down this season compared to previous years. The Guardians showed their grit by rallying to win the opening game of the series, and they have the advantage on the mound in this contest. Give Cleveland the upper hand in this one as they take the series. Our team pick is Cleveland Guardians. Cleveland won their third straight and fifth in the last 6 games, as they rallied from an early 4-0 deficit to win in extra innings Friday night. The Guardians improved to 30-33 on the year and went into Saturday second in the AL Central, 1.5 games behind the Twins for the top spot. On Friday night, Cleveland got 3 hits each from Jose Ramirez, 2 runs, RBI, and Miles Straw, run, in the contest to lead a 14-hit attack. Ramirez hit his 10th homer of the season and 4th in the last 2 games for the Guardians. Logan Allen didn't factor in the decision after allowing 5 runs on 9 hits with 2 walks and 4 strikeouts over 6 innings. Xavien Curry, 3-0, earned the win in relief after allowing 1 run, none earned, on 1 hit with no walks or strikeouts in 1 inning of work. Our total pick: these two certainly put up ahead of runs in the first game of the series, with 7 of the 19 runs coming in extra innings. The Cleveland offense seems to be heating up, scoring 25 runs in a 3-game span. They also get going when Bieber is on the hill, scoring 4.35 runs per 9 innings when he pitches. Overall, Houston's offense is in the top half of pretty much all relevant statistical categories. So, even if they are in a bit of a rut, they have weapons that can snap to attention at a moment's notice. I think we scrape by here, but I do like for this to be another game with some runs. Take the over. Oakland Athletics vs. Milwaukee Brewers. The Athletics are playing well at the moment, and they've won 3 of their last 4 games. They will try to keep the momentum going with another win over the Brewers, which will give them their 4th win in their last 5 games, and their 2nd consecutive series win. Oakland is averaging 3.62 runs per game. Their .224 batting average is 29th in the league. Their .306 on base percentage is 25th, while their .358 slugging percentage is 29th. Brent Rooker has been the most consistent batter for the Athletics. He leads the team with a .263 batting average, 12 home runs, and 36 RBI. Oakland's pitching isn't very good, with the team giving up 6.65 runs per game. Opponents have a .276 batting average against the Athletics, which is 30th in the league. Their 6.50 ERA is 30th, as is their 1.61 WHIP. In his last start, Sears gave up 2 hits and 1 run in 4.2 innings, but the team lost to Pittsburgh 5-4. They will need another solid start from him if they want to get the win. The Athletics have won 3 of their last 4 road games. Even though they have one of the worst offenses in the league, they are playing very well at the moment, scoring 25 runs in their last 3 road games. Expect them to play well offensively in this game because they've had more success against right-handers, and Peralta has struggled on the mound in recent starts, giving up 15 runs in his last 3 starts. He gave up 13 runs in his last 3 home starts, and will have a hard time slowing down the Athletics in this game. The Brewers have lost 3 of their last 5 games, and 5 of their last 8 home games. Despite their slump, they have played well offensively, scoring 15 runs in their last 3 home games. But, they will struggle offensively in this game because they have struggled against left-handers, and Sears has done a good job on the mound in recent starts, giving up 5 runs in his last 4 starts. He gave up 4 runs in his last 3 road starts and will keep Milwaukee's offense in check. Go with Oakland to cover the money line. The Brewers didn't play well over the past week, and they've lost 3 of their last 5 games. They are tied with Pittsburgh in the NL Central standings and will try to retake sole possession of the division lead with a win over the Athletics, which will give them their 3rd win in their last 6 games. Milwaukee is averaging 4.06 runs per game. Their .230 batting average is 25th in the league. Their .306 on base percentage is 24th, while their .378 slugging percentage is 26th. Christian Yelich leads Milwaukee with a .254 batting average. Rowdy Tellez leads the team with 12 home runs, while Brian Anderson leads the team with 32 RBI. Milwaukee's pitching has been good, with the team giving up 4.34 runs per game. Opponents have a .242 batting average against the Brewers, which is 10th in the league. Their 4.05 ERA is 12th, while their 1.28 WHIP is 14th. In his last start, Peralta gave up 6 hits and 2 runs in 5 innings, leading to a 4-3 win over Baltimore. They will need a similar effort from him if they want to win this game. Both teams will struggle to score runs in this matchup. The under will hit in this contest. Take the under, 7.5 runs. Miami Marlins vs. Chicago White Sox. The Marlins will have Braxton Garrett on the mound to conclude the series. Garrett wasn't sharp in his previous start, conceding 4 runs in 5 innings against the Royals, and was able to come away with a win. The young lefty has been solid, limiting his opponent to 2 or fewer runs in 4 of his last 5 outings, and has improved his ERA to 4.47, along with a 1.30 WHIP and a 2-2 record in 58.1 innings. This marks his first career meeting against the White Sox. The Miami Marlins are playing well, but have benefited from an easy schedule recently. Their last 6 games prior to this series have been against the 2 worst teams in baseball, the A's and the Royals. Chicago has been solid, winning 6 of their last 8 games. Furthermore, Marlins left-handed starter Braxton Garrett just allowed 4 runs last time out. He is a lefty and the White Sox have been more dangerous against lefties, posting a solid .744 OPS against left-handed starters, compared to only a .666 OPS against righties. White Sox starter Lucas Giolito just tossed 6 shutout innings against the Yankees last time out and has a stellar 2.70 ERA and a 3-1 record at home this season. Our total pick is Chicago White Sox. Lucas Giolito will be on the mound in the final game of the series. Giolito came through with one of his best outings in his previous start, posting 6 scoreless innings against the potent Yankees offense, and was able to collect the victory. The veteran righty is having an inconsistent season but is capable of outstanding performances. Giolito has recorded a 4.08 ERA and a 1.26 WHIP, accompanied by a 4-4 record and 68.1 innings pitched on the season. This is his first career meeting against the Marlins. Our total pick is over. Cincinnati Reds vs. St. Louis Cardinals. Cincinnati's season has been defined by streaks this season. There have been 10 instances of the Reds winning or losing at least 3 in a row, with Saturday's game presenting an opportunity for an 11th streak. If they're on a down streak right now, it's a bad time considering they're still only 5.0 games back in the NL Central. Pitching has been the Reds' problem, as they're 28th in baseball with a 5.08 ERA. Only one starting rotation has been worse than Cincinnati's, although this game's starter, Hunter Green, has been a bright spot. Green has a 3.11 road ERA in 7 starts, and most of that damage was done in Denver. He has a 33.0% strikeout rate, which would be 4th in the majors with enough innings to qualify, and is emerging as the Reds' ace of the future. With Hunter Green on the mound, the Reds are the better bet in this game. He's been money on the road and needs run support for it to translate to wins. Fortunately, the Reds get to bat against Adam Wainwright, who has been awful this season. Cincinnati tagged Wainwright for 5 runs once this season, so there's proof that they can get to him. Green can keep St. Louis's offense down, and Cincinnati's surprisingly solid bullpen can lock it down. The Reds leave St. Louis with a win. Despite having the reigning NL MVP, a 2022 division crown to defend, and a roster that seemed as complete as any, the Cardinals have spent most of the season in the NL Central's basement. A May surge had them flying high, but they've come back down to earth since then. Pitching has also plagued St. Louis throughout 2023, and Adam Wainwright hasn't been a solution. The veteran is currently posting career worst in WHIP, H9, strikeout rate, and ERA+. He allowed 5 runs in 5.2 innings of work against the Reds in May, his worst outing of the season. Wino still knows how to keep pitches in the park, but he's also still getting hit hard. The stats and trends suggest a lower scoring affair between these two teams on Sunday. Take the under 9 runs. San Diego Padres vs. Colorado Rockies. San Diego picked up a win in the first game of the series, as Yu Darvish earned his 100th career win, and the Padres lineup launched 5 home runs. are fun times ahead for Friars faithful. Colorado has dropped 5 straight decisions and 8 of its last 10 games. The Rockies are 13 games out of first place in the NL West. Colorado sports a 29-28 run line record as an underdog and a 13-12 run line record as a home underdog this year. The Padres have a 20-22 run line record as favorites and a 9-10 run line record versus their NL West rivals. Lamet was a Padre for the first 4.5 years of his career, so he has plenty of knowledge of the Friars. I predict he'll perform well enough to keep the home team within striking distance, hence the Rockies run line pick. Our team pick is Rockies run line. He under is 4-0 the last 4 times that Snell started on a Sunday, and 6-1 the last 7 times he started the third game of a series. Take the under. Chicago Cubs vs. San Francisco Giants. By taking a glance at Chicago's results over roughly 20 games, one can probably point out every time Marcus Stroman started, especially after Friday's win. Otherwise, this Cubs team is in a brutal tailspin. Since May 29, Chicago is only putting up 2.27 runs per game. They've fallen to 21st in runs per game this year, despite MLB's third highest walk rate. It doesn't help that they're 25th in strikeout rate, 20th in slugging percentage, and playing without Cody Bellinger, who looked rejuvenated at the plate. Still, long stretches of lifelessness like the one they're in is how seasons go to waste. Chicago's offense cannot be trusted. They have exceeded 3 runs in a game twice in June, the same amount of times they've been shut out. The Giants may not have a clear, to us, pitching plan yet, but whoever comes in should be able to toss zeros. Hayden Wesneski has pitched well lately, but it won't matter if the offense and bullpen let him down. It's happened far too often. The home fans will have plenty to cheer for in this one. Our team pick is San Francisco Giants money line. While the Cubs can only win consistently on Stroman starts, the Giants can't win at home right now. Friday's loss made them 1-5 in their last 6 home contests. They've also lost 5 of their last 6 Sunday games. San Francisco also has issues offensively, particularly with striking out. Only the Twins have a higher strikeout rate than the Giants this season. The Giants are reliant on the long ball, with the 9th most in the majors. It leads to the 12th most runs per game. This is a team that can explode on any day, but can also be blanked by a sharp pitcher. The over should cover in a high-scoring game with both lineups stepping up. Take the over on 8 runs. Seattle Mariners vs. Los Angeles Angels. The Seattle Mariners fell to 30-32 on the season following Friday's defeat at Angel Stadium. It was their second straight loss and the 7th in 9 games, as the Mariners have dropped 2 of their previous 3 series, along with a 2-game split against the San Diego Padres on the road. I like Seattle's chances in this game. The current Mariners are 6-4-25 with 5 doubles against Griffin Canning, who ranks in the 35th percentile in expected slugging percentage in 2023. Canning's 4-seam fastball, 31.3% of usage, has a +4 run value, and the M's are more dangerous when hitting the lefties. Over the last 2 weeks, the Mariners have recorded a 104 WRC plus against the southpaws and 72 WRC plus against the righties, while the Angels have registered a 110 WRC plus versus the lefties and 119 WRC plus against right-handed pitchers. Bryce Miller can only pitch better than he did last time out, when he yielded 7 runs in 2.1 innings of work against the Texas Rangers, whose offense has been unstoppable lately. The Angels have never met Miller and might struggle to get to the talented righty. Our team pick is Seattle Mariners. The Los Angeles Angels moved to 35-30 on the season following Tuesday's narrow victory over the Mariners, extending their winning streak to 5 games. Shohei Ohtani and Mickey Moniak smacked a 2-run homer apiece, and the Halos bullpen did a good job once more, allowing 1 run through 4 innings, after Ohtani gave up 3 runs on 3 hits and 5 walks. Additionally, both bullpens rank securely in the top half of the MLB, with ERAs well under 4.00. Runs should be few and far between in this one. Give me the under 9.5 runs. Boston Red Sox vs. New York Yankees. The Red Sox got some bad news this week, with the announcement that starter Chris Sale was being moved to the 60-day Illinois with a shoulder issue, but the team has welcomed back CF Adam Duvall to a lineup that is desperate for right-handed power. Duvall could soon be followed by Trevor Story as well, which would give a slumping Red Sox lineup a shot in the arm. On Friday night, the Red Sox lineup produced just 3 runs, but it was enough to upend the Yankees to end a 2-game losing streak. On Saturday night, the Red Sox offense left 10 runners on base, and starter Tanner Houck allowed 2 solo home runs in a 3-1 loss to even the series at a game apiece. The Red Sox have a good chance to close out the finale with a win against a Yankees team with a relatively toothless lineup at the moment. Without Judge and, to a lesser extent, Harrison Bader, the Yankees are missing significant pop. The duo has combined for 25 home runs, a quarter of the team's long ball production this season. The Yankees are hitting just .238 at home this season and are just 7-10 this season with Judge out of the lineup. Boston starter Bello has better numbers on the road and should find this Yankees lineup much easier to navigate without the fear of Judge in the two-hole. Boston, meanwhile, should be able to do damage against Schmidt in this matchup. The return of Duvall gives the Red Sox middle of the order much more pop and allows the Red Sox to balance out the order more. Case in point, Keiko Hernandez belted his sixth home run out of the ninth spot in the order on Friday night. Rafael Devers also had his best game in over a month on Friday, with a double and a home run, hitting in front of Duvall. Additionally, the Yankees are just 4-9 in games started by Schmidt. Take the Red Sox with the money line. The Yankees are trying to navigate the offensive waters without the team's top hitter in Aaron Judge. Judge remains out with a toe injury, and the Yankees have gone 2-3 heading into Saturday night's game in his absence. The Bombers' offense has produced just 16 runs in that span, including just 2 runs on Friday night against Boston. Gerrit Cole lost his first game of the season on Friday night, continuing a slow downward trend in his last 5 starts, since looking like a Cy Young favorite in his first 7 starts of the season. On Saturday night, the Yankees got 6 solid innings from Domingo German and solo home runs from Gleyber Torres and Willie Calhoun, on their way to a 3-1 win to even the weekend series. Our total pick is over.